charts has to offer, and also going to show you how to put one of these charts into your FileMaker system via a web viewer. So first I'd like to show the charts that are specific to Google Charts. They offer lots of different ones that FileMaker can use, but also they have some fairly unique ones. We have a geographical chart. As you can see, it shows different values based on different regions, different countries. Most of these are offered by FileMaker, but some of them, like organizational chart, tree map, we have there. We also have timeline, gauge, and candlestick charts. And you can read more about that in the article. So today I'm going to show you how to put a specifically put a scatter chart into FileMaker, and with a trend in mind. So just want to show different kinds of options you can employ in these charts. I'm going to scroll way down here to the options, and this is where you're going to find the documentation for the options, how to use them, and basically what they do. So that's pretty important stuff, and you can find this on all the different kinds of charts. So I'm going to open up the sample file. Just a sec here. Okay, so if you open it up, it should look like this. You're gonna and the main chart I wanted to focus on was trend for vehicle sales price per model year. So I wanted to start off with the current year and then show how the older the car is when it's sold, how the price looks. And I mean, of course, you're gonna see a negative trend line right there, but want to compare between two different cars, the way that trend line looks. And so as you can see here, it's a pretty steady decline. We do have a little bit of tapering off here, and so that kind of shows you that the vehicle is somewhat reliable. You know, you can kind of extrapolate some information from that. We also have some outliers here, but I'm going to show you kind of maybe a better example of what you should be seeing. So right here I changed the make to Jeep and the model to Wrangler, and we can see a lot more data right here. And so depending on this data, say if we had lots of outliers up top here, this line would kind of shift up, and you would be able to see that shift. But again, another negative trend, but you can see it's kind of curving more towards this. So what we can do is we can change this to a polynomial curve, and it defaults to a degree of 2. You can change that, but for the most part, it's going to look pretty much the same no matter what degree in this instance. But that is an option if you ever wanted to do that. So as we can see here, we have a curve where this kind of tapers off, and we can see that customers, in this case, customers are willing to pay. They're willing to pay a fairly high price for older vehicles, which can show you that maybe the vehicles are really reliable, and you can actually ask for higher prices for older vehicles. So this would be like kind of the average of what you'd want to set the price for, maybe a little above that. But that's how this trend line is going to inform your business decisions. So that's more of an overview. Now I'm going to kind of get into the nitty gritty, and we'll show you how to actually put this in your system. So what I did here was I set up the HTML and JavaScript right in the web viewer. First, I just want to make sure that you know that you'll need to automatically encode that URL, but then you can select custom web address and set all this. So just have a big let statement, and the HTML equals all this stuff. But for the most part, we're actually using JavaScript. So we have some script declarations right here, and then just a bunch of setup and quite a bit of options, but the main part you probably want to focus on is this data right here. So this data is going to be loaded from this global right here, And I will get into that later, but that global is gonna be set from your FileMaker data. We have a couple of option parameters. So we have the trend line type, and we have the degree. And so we can see right here in under one of these options, we have a trend line, and you can set multiple trend lines. We just have one right here, but you could do like 0, 1, 2, etc., and just have some options. And so we have type right here, and we have degree right here. Now, if let's say that we have linear, but there still is a degree. Google Charts is smart enough that it'll know that, oh, this is linear, this degree option doesn't really apply, so we're just going to skip over that. And that's why I can have that set up that way. But yeah, the basic idea of this is we're going to have some script set up. They'll be loading some packages and declaring how to draw the chart with the options, then declaring the chart and drawing it all in JavaScript, and then setting up the HTML. And then the last bit right here is to make sure that you set up the URL with this right before it so that it encodes properly. It's data text slash HTML, and then you'll be good to go. Okay. So now that we have that, I'm going to show you the script to run to generate this information, and it's fairly simple. We'll get a little bit into that, but all we're really doing is checking for user error, and then once we have all that, set this variable data array to this summary, and then just set it to the global. So let us. I'm just gonna go into the data into manage database, file manage database, and then we'll go to our vehicle table, and we have this ZS scatter plot array, which is a list of these items, and these items are just setting up an array, a JavaScript-friendly array, and we're just setting year and sale amount, and then just have a comma right there, and so we're just having a list of all of those, and then it'll be nice and formatted for your HTML. So pretty straightforward, a few components there, but yeah, that is the general overview of this sample file.